Welcome to week 20 of your 40-week pregnancy journey. Congratulations, you have made it the halfway point. To celebrate, you may be able to find out your baby's sex this week, if you are so inclined. Now's also the perfect time to sign up for a birthing class if you haven't already done it. Your baby's development at week 20. By this week's end, your baby-to-be will weigh about 9 ounces and he or she will stretch to about 7.5 inches long. Your baby is the size of a bell pepper this week. Your baby is completely covered in vernix, the creamy substance protecting his delicate skin from the amniotic fluid. By this week of pregnancy, your baby is truly starting to experience the world around him. Beside the rolling, diving and kicking, you might be feeling the rhythmic jerking of your baby during this week. Most babies get the hiccups in utero, possibly due to an immature diaphragm having spasms. No need to worry though, they are not causing him or her any harm. The sonograph shows that your baby's heart beats around 140 beats per minute this week. Your common symptoms this week. The symptoms you may experience during this week might include: Number 1. Heartburns. Early in pregnancy, your body produces large amounts of hormones, progesterone and relaxin, which tend to relax smooth muscle tissues throughout your body, including those in your gastrointestinal tract. Heartburns occur when the ring of the muscle that separates the esophagus from the stomach relaxes, allowing the food and harsh digestive juices to back up from the stomach to the esophagus. Number 2. Dizziness and faintedness. Early in pregnancy, your body is gearing up to meet the needs of two bodies instead of one. Dizziness is likely due to several factors such as: your body is not yet producing enough blood to fill rapidly expanding circulatory system. Your growing uterus can put pressure on your blood vessels, especially when you are lying on your back. If your blood sugar drops or you become dehydrated, you're more likely to experience a dizzy spell. Number 3. Belly button changes. Most women find that their navel begins changing around the end of second trimester of pregnancy. Your rapidly expanding uterus pushes your abdomen forward, making your most inverted innie belly button become an outie. It is not as harmful as people think because your belly button will get right back to its regular position a few months after delivery. There is nothing you can do to prevent changes to your navel during pregnancy. So here are some self-care tips during this week. Some of the self-care tips which you should follow during this week are: Number 1. Treating heartburns. There are several ways to control and treat heartburn during pregnancy, and with so many options and so much time, you'll probably try them all, such as: chew on sugarless gums, add almonds to your diet because eating a few almonds after each meal, since they are very tasty and neutralize the juices in the stomach, which may relieve and prevent heartburn. Get milk, eat fresh, dried or freeze-dried papaya as it helps to relieve heartburn for some women and scores vitamin A and vitamin C too. Number 2. Preventing dizziness and faintedness. To keep dizziness away from your body at first place, you should try out the following things such as: go slowly, don't get up too quickly when you are sitting or lying down, make the most of the munchies, that is eating a healthy, well-rounded diet during pregnancy with a mixture of protein and complete carbs, feast frequently, fill up with fluids, make sure that you are drinking enough water, which may include 12 to 13 glasses of fluids. Dressing smart, which means avoid wearing tight-fitting clothes, scarves and hats. Don't lie on your back. Get some fresh air. Spending too much time in stuffy, overheated indoor spaces can trigger dizziness. So in the nutshell, here is your week 20 checklist. Continue taking prenatal vitamins. Continue drinking about 8 to 12 glasses of water a day to keep yourself hydrated and prevent that dizziness and faintedness. Continue taking a nightly bath to help with your pain and sleep. Make it a point to stop crossing your legs as it will put pressure on your baby to be. Thank you. Please like, subscribe and share our YouTube channel The Voice of Woman and press the bell icon to stay tuned for the latest updates.